And was your best friend also the best friend of Oco Kero?
You got to hang out with him?
Yeah. I have given a rope to tie him and take him, like, you know.
Oh, you gave the rope to the cops?
That's what the first month I had joined. And I know, never knew what was happening. They asked me to get a rope, so I brought the rope from the well and gave him a thick one. They tied him around and took him in Ambassador car.
I don't know who said life's a bitch and then you die. But lying down on a beautiful beach, sipping cold beers is my way of dealing with this pandemic. Susigad style. I even managed to convince Shanky the Happy Forker to join me here in Goa.
Season 2 in Goa meant fish, meats, and a whole lot of booze. With the both of us there, I'm sure we're gonna revive the economy one plate at a time. Here's to the best goddamn food guide to Goa.
Tum log kya chutiya bhai karwa rahe ho hamare se? It's a little village called Pillen. It's a real ideal little town, not overdeveloped. So we're having lunch with Nolan's mom, Odette, and his dad, Joe. She's written a bunch of books, and she, I think, writes for a couple of newspapers. She's a food critique. But more than that, they're very passionate about traditional Goan food. So we're at Chef Peter's kitchen. We're gonna go get down on some Lusa cuisine.
It's the cutest kitchen ever, though.
All right, on that note, let this voyage begin. Ah, what a welcome.
Thank you.
I actually don't know much about Lusa cuisine. Is that what you're cooking?
See, there's a difference between Lusa cuisine, Christian Goan cuisine, Hindu Goan cuisine, plus the Portuguese-inspired Portuguese. Okay. We are cooking more of the inspired Portuguese.
So let me do this again. You have Goan Christian, the regular, which is Konkani style.
Exactly.
Right, that's one. And then you have inspired Portuguese. And this is the mix of Konkani and inspired.
Exactly. Lusa cuisine is like this croquet, risoise.
Yeah, yeah.
Then the empanada, which you don't do. Empire.
Like an empanada. Empanada in Spanish is empanada. Okay.
Those stuff is totally Portuguese.
Correct.
Yeah, yeah. Portuguese.
Correct.
Also, the sorpater, vindalo, caldim, they are also Portuguese, but not exactly come from the Portuguese, what we are doing.
Ah, okay.
They are
adapted to local
food. Adapted, we have changed it to our palates.
Is the south of Goa more famous for its Lusa cuisine? Is that true or is that just a false belief?
No, it is.
It is,
but not to all the houses, not all the restaurants. There are a lot of Portuguese spoken and there are Brahmins down there.
Brahmins that have converted?
Converted. And they are the ones who have kept this origin
like
of Portuguese.
Like this tradition, yeah.
Yeah, origin of Portuguese because they knew what it is.
Right.
So your cuisine is basically this is more local to here.
Yeah.
But like you said, it's inspired by also Portuguese cuisine.
So you say that Cazarazzo stew.
So rest I recognize that. I don't know what is that.
You won't find it anyway.
I've never seen it.
That Cazarazzo stew, it's a forgotten totally. Because beef is there, there's pork. And there is sausage mixing.
All three. This is boy is going to jump joy.
I'm in heaven already.
I said we say that with a mallu accent. Okay.
And also, we make salted pork. Now this salted pork was like before. We did not have fridges to store the.
Preserve it.
So this is
preservation.
This was pressed, means with the salt. Applied and then pressed it out.
What did he make for you that you decide, okay, this man I will marry.
He gave him a haircut.
Not
for food.
Not for food. Oh man, look at that. So better than you, better than something else than I'm not asking what it is. That is your private life.
So when you talk about Portugal, remember Portugal was not a very big nation. They could not afford to have the soldiers and everyone to sort of look after their colonies. So they used to bring in a lot of people from the African countries like Mozambique, etc., which was one of their colonies. Those people, when they came and settled down as soldiers in Goa, they were known as the Capris. And they used to do a lot of grilled stuff, bush grilling, with a little bit of their, herbs put in and grill the chicken, grill the meat, etc. So they watch these guys doing this, and they themselves fine-tune their own chicken, which was a leg and a breast, marinated overnight with all those spices, and Indianized spices, by the way. Remember coriander, green coriander was only seasonal at that time. So basically when the chicken was prepared also was important. And then they did not know what to call it, because over years we have realized that most of the preparations have been given Portuguese names, because for want of the so-called link, you know, between that. So they decided to call it Cafrial after the Capris, who basically got that preparation done.
There is another, may I?
Yes, coming in from Mozambique.
That is not the story he knew, I guarantee you that.
Yeah, no.
So he went fully intrigued into that. So he was hearing it for the first time, I can guarantee.
Yeah, this was what I was hearing. Yeah. But very similar, except there's also, because I believe some of it has been gentrified, not to sound cruel, but there is a cruelty to this name. I'll tell you where it comes
from. Cafrial.
So all the colonizers called Africans, there's a certain name for them. And I have to say this for television. It starts with a K. It's called Kaffa. I'm saying it, I know half my friends in all of that part of the world are just cringing, because you go to jail in Africa for this. Kaffir means a black person. If you were ruling them, if you were a colonizer, that's how you term them. This is a Kaffir. This is a Kaffir's meal.
So yeah, possibly the Kaffir.
Yeah, so, but the Kaffir is a nicer way, they changed. But the origin of it is a slightly crueler.
Now, there's a very interesting thing what Peter has done. Now, again, this is because of centuries of, I would say, the Hindu community thinking and the Christian community thinking.
It's an amalgamation of
It's an amalgamation of thoughts, ideas, and even the processes when it comes to cooking. Let's take an example. If you use the continental thing, they normally use breadcrumbs. If you go to a Hindu community kitchen, they will use either rice flour or semolina. Here, he has used a combination of breadcrumbs and semolina.
Is the prawn in something like a bechamel or something?
Yeah.
It's a bechamel, right? Bechamel. Got it right.
You're pure Portuguese.
The bechamel.
The cheese inside.
What cheese? But a very light cheese, yeah. Right? Like a very provoletta kind of cheese that's going in there. I said I had croquettes, I don't want croquettes. That would have been a cardinal sin. This is so good.
These are all his secret masalas, which he adds inside.
I love that little green chilies also. I'm not a big fan of the
Though he's put very little, and I'm sure because of his customers, he's added that.
Mm. Oh my God, I have not had this.
This is all fish.
Okay. No filler nonsense.
Yeah. I mean, little bread and all stuffing.
No bread, stuffing.
Just made the cake sense.
Yeah.
Now, this is as close to the Portuguese style of making this rice.
Mm. Yeah, these I would call fish cakes, not fish cutlets.
We are having our own lit fest right here. We are eat fest, lit fest. All right, I gotta see if I can get these names right the way I remember them. Madame et Monsieur. I forgot how to say this. This is the fucking menu of the day. Menu du jour, les plats royales, la crème germanie, les filets de
confrère. Germain, that is pea soup.
Pea soup, yeah.
Pâté germain.
Pâté germain. La poulade.
I think you'll get it right with a sip.
It cleans up the tongue. Les petits pois frais au beurre. Ah, pomme soufflé. Potato soufflé. Okay, don't make fun of me, fuckers. Pomme is because it's called pomme de terre, which means apple of the soil. I think in this heat, the crabs are generally going to be a little sweet. The meat is going to be sweet. We might not need that much onion or sauteed onion in there, because it amps up the sweet way too much. But still, I mean, it evokes Portugal.
Let me take a different take on it. Yes, the flavor, I agree. I normally have a problem with slightly sweet, but I've never had crab like this. It's a different take around here, at least in these parts.
So this, you said, is quite historical, but it has got a new take on it. It's a Goan Portuguese party in my mouth. Everything. Oh.
This is the salted pork chili fry.
And I like the way there's a little bit of fat and meat, and the fat makes everything just melt together. Kokum and a little green chili to kick it up.
And interestingly, it also has jackfruit seeds in it. My mallu roots, I keep going back to that. I love the simplicity of this dish.
The king and queen not eating.
We are supposed to taste, we're not supposed to eat.
Yeah, look, no, that's why
we're all on holiday, so it's fine for you.
We're always on holiday.
You take me to another state and see me hog away to glory.
Ah, fair enough.
Oh, she's not bland at all.
No, he's.
I have a feeling he's probably put chorizo in it.
There is chorizo.
Hoga. There has to be. So that's your flavor base. This is the tongue. This is why I talk too much. I have too much tongue.
She never complained. It's the perfect for sandwiches.
Make a
sandwich. Have one with the bread. And there's onion also there. Okay, what is y'all have eaten solan pile? What do you feel?
Sanna.
Sanna.
With this. Need the sweet. Compliment. So on the salty side, sanna compliments it. But I also like the little big chunks of chili with it. But really. Red. Now, you know. This is my dilemma. A little bit piece of bread, that's sitting there, that's sitting there.
That's what I said, just go for it. Go for it. What else is balance?
I don't care. I got no shame in this game.
It's nice to see a hearty eater.
Has it got a urad or something?
It's got dal.
Dal, eh, na? Some of dal is toasted, some of dal is not toasted. You get these two layers of dal, I'm getting.
It's quite nice though.
Yeah. Midi dal. No, it's like, there's a lot going on here. This is exemplary. This is outside the norm. This is outside of what everybody thinks they're getting in Goa. This is tradition handled by a master.
Homestyle.
Yeah, and homestyle.
The ending. We forgot to
load. I will fucking kill you.
That was a very natural.
Seriously?
Yeah.
No, that is what he wanted as a reaction of yours. He got that reaction now. That producer behind his mask,
yeah,
there is that.
He's a smart guy.
Bohot harami hai tu.
You keep on saying that you're not an actor, so they're getting you a natural avatar.
Oh, what is that method actor? Method actor. Go into role. Asshole. I had learned a little bit about Lusa cuisine. I've had some of the dishes before. From A to Z, it was an experience of something I am not that familiar with, but I am comfortable with. Chef Peter, he's a traditionalist. He does things his way. A lot of people have changed cuisine to make non-Goans feel comfortable. What I like about him is I don't think they do that much. Did everything work for me? No. Do I know the cuisine that well? No. But I'm on a voyage of discovery. We're learning. Maybe I'll learn to appreciate it more.
For me, it was more like reading a Wikipedia page where, for the first time, where you start seeing and discovering things absolutely new. So every bite that went into my mouth was like, I don't know what to relate this to. Irrespective, it was something new. And after 35 years, when you have something new, it feels like, what the hell? Suddenly you find something new right in your backyard. I wouldn't go to the extent to say whether it is for everybody or not. Try it out for yourself, because you might just like it, you might not like it. Producer enjoyed my reaction when I had that squid. When that thing burst in my mouth, I thought the squid took a in my mouth. And for a second, I was like,
I liked it.
I actually, in the video, you can go back and see, I took a second squid also later on to see whether I have the same masochism in me. Whether does it taste better the second time? It didn't. Like, share,
and
subscribe.
Ghanta. What fucking public shit?
Press the bell.
This one.
Why don't you do it like
this? Ghanta bajao, ghanta. Something to do with subscribers.
What do you do? Subscribe.
Yeah, subscribe. We are shit at this, right?